force and pressure. In the first, we are going to deal with force. What is force? What do you mean by force? According to physics, we can define force as a push or pull. Here you can see a chair. It is in the state of rest. When I apply force, when I push it, the chair moves. When I pull, you can see again the chair moves. So a push or pull can be explained as force. Next is, a force can change the shape or size of a body. So here you can see it is in rubber bands. You can see the size changes. Size of the rubber band changes on stretching it. So a stretch is a force. Next we can see it is a clay. We can change the shape of the clay on squeezing it. When I squeeze, the shape of the clay changes. So these are the second two conditions of applying force can change the shape and size of a body. Next is, a force can stop a moving body. Here it was a moving body. When I apply the force, the moving body stops by applying force. So I conclude, what is force or what are the effects of force? A force can move a body at rest. Second one, a force can stop a body in motion. Third, a force can change the shape of the body. And the fourth one, a force can change the size of a body. Next we can see which are the main points coming under force. A force will not change the mass of a body. If I squeeze it, I am applying the force, but the mass remains constant. So a force will not change the mass of a body. Second point is, a force, we cannot see the force. Can you see the force? No. But someone slap on your face, you are not able to see the force. But obviously you can feel it while slapping. You will feel the force. So we are not able to see the force, but we can feel it. And the third point, the last point is, the force will be always explained in terms of a magnitude and a unit, because force is a physical quantity. We already studied, for a force or for a physical quantity will be explained in two terms, a magnitude and unit. So I can say, I just squeeze this gum or squeeze this clay, the force applied by my hand is 5 newton. That means 5 is the magnitude and newton is the SI unit of force. So we are going to study in detail about the SI unit of force. So the SI unit of force is newton. It is named after the scientist Sir Isaac Newton. So the SI unit of force is newton. So how will you define 1 newton? 1 newton is defined as the force which applies on a body of mass 1 kilogram, which moves the body or which increases its speed by 1 meter per second. In 1 second, then we can say that the force applied on the body is 1 newton. Another unit of force is kgf, kilogram force. So how is this kilogram force related to newton? We already studied the acceleration due to gravity at a place is 9.8 meter per second square. So if we are taking acceleration due to gravity is 9.8, then we can compare the relation. 1 kgf is 9.8 newton. Or we can compare it with newton as 1 kgf is equal to 10 newton. If you are taking the acceleration due to gravity is 10 newton. So how will you define this kgf? 1 kgf means it is defined as the force exerted, or we want to exert a force to hold a mass of 100 gram. Suppose this duster is 100 gram. How much force I am exerting to hold this 100 gram mass is termed as 1 kgf. Next is, how does the effect of force differ when it applies on a rigid body and non-rigid body? Okay, what do you mean by a rigid body? Here you can see this ball, or this ball is a rigid body. and this clay is a non-rigid body. So while applying force on a rigid body, it will move the object. That means when I apply force, here you can see the board, it can move, it can be moved. So force applied on a rigid body will make the body move. At the same time, the force applied on a non-rigid body, it will, the effect of force on a non-rigid body is, it will change the size or shape of a body. Next, we are going to study the next topic coming under force. It is turning effect of force. We are going to study about turning effect of force. So, as we already studied, when we apply force on a rigid body, which is free to move, it will move in a straight line. Just now I show you the example. When I push this board, it moves in a straight line. Okay, push or pull, the object moves in a straight path because the board is not fixed. But here, this CD, you can see the CD, it is fixed. It is pivoted. We'll use the term pivoted at its center. Now, when I apply the force, will the body move in a straight line? No, it will just rotate. This effect is known as turning effect. That means we are applying force on a body which is pivoted at its center. We can say that the body will rotate. And this effect is known as turning effect. Another name of turning effect will say it as torque. Or the third name is moment of force. M-O-M-E-N-T. Moment of force. So here, what are the factors which depends on the turning effect? You know, I am applying force. So obviously the first factor will be the force. Here you can see the magnitude of force. What do you mean magnitude of force? I am applying 5 Newton. 5 is the magnitude. So I am applying 5 Newton. So 5. If we increase the force, increase the magnitude, the turning effect will also increase. Okay, so the first factor on turning effect is magnitude of force. Second factor is perpendicular distance of the force from the pivoted point. Here my finger is the pivoted point. Perpendicular distance, the straight distance from the pivoted point to the position where I am applying the force. This distance is the second factor on which turning effect depends. So as we increase the force applied, turning effect increases. At the same time, when we increase the distance, when we increase the distance of the applying force, perpendicular distance increases, then also turning effect will increase. So this concept, that is, as the distance increases, turning effect will also increase, can be demonstrated by different examples. First application of turning effect of force. Here you can see, here is the pivoted point, that is fixed point of the dog. You can see the handle. We can open or close the door by holding it at the handle. That means force we are applying. Here is the hinges. This is the perpendicular distance from the pivoted point to the handle. As the perpendicular distance increases, it will be easy for us to open or close the door. As I give larger force, you can see the turning effect will also increase. So, as we increase the force, turning effect increases. As we increase the distance from the pivoted point to the handle, handle means where we are applying the force, then also we can increase the force. That is why we are applying, we are placing the handle at the extreme end, because at the extreme end means it has a maximum distance from the hinges, from the pivoted point. Larger the distance, larger will be the turning effect. Next application of turning effect is the working of a spanner. Here you all are familiar with the spanner. It is used to tighten or loosen a nut. So for this, if we have to hold the nut in this gap, and we used to hold the spanner at the next extreme end, so that we can apply less force while opening or or tightening or loosening a nerve. Instead of this place, if I am holding it in the middle, what will happen? We should apply more force. So we should hold the spanner at the extreme end. That means here should be the pivoted point. From the pivoted point to the extreme end, as the distance increases, larger the perpendicular distance, larger will be the moment of force, so that we need to apply only less force. Here we can see the next example of turning effect of force. It is a hand floor grinder. The handle is provided at the maximum end to provide less force, to provide maximum turning effect with less force. We have to apply less force because handle is provided at the maximum end. Next application of turning effect is potter's wheel. Turning of a potter's wheel. A potter's wheel has a wheel pivoted at the center. The potter turns the wheel by a means of a stick at the rim of the wheel. Larger the perpendicular distance, more will be the turning effect by applying less effort. Example of turning effect is turning of a drill machine. A carpenter uses a drill machine which is provided with a handle, so that by applying a less force at the end of the handle, the drill can easily turn. As the perpendicular distance increases, the turning effect will also increase. Next application of turning effect is turning of a steering wheel. To turn a steering wheel in a car or truck, the driver applies force at the point on the rim of the wheel. Larger the distance, perpendicular distance, more will be the turning effect. I think now all of you understood all the applications of turning effect of force. Now we are going to study about its SI unit. Since the force or the moment of force is a physical quantity, it should have an SI unit. So here you can see the formula for moment of force or turning effect of force. Both are same, turning effect of force or moment of force. Formula is moment of force is equal to force into perpendicular distance. That's we are applying a force. Moment of force is turning effect. Okay, normal force into perpendicular distance. What is the SI unit of force? SI unit of force is Newton. And perpendicular distance, distance means our length. SI unit of length is meter. So the turning effect of force, the SI unit is Newton meter. Okay, then what is 1 Newton? 1 Newton is 10 raised to 5 die. The CGS unit of force is die. How the SI unit and CGS unit related? 1 Newton is 10 raised to 5 die. And second one, meter. When you are converting into CGS unit, in CGS unit, the unit of length is centimeter. So 1 meter is 100 centimeter. So we can write 1 Newton meter is 10 raised to 5 die into 100 centimeter. Instead of 100, we can write 10 square. So 10 raised to 5 die into 10 square centimeter. So while adding a raised to m into a raised to n, a raised to m plus n, that is 10 raised to 5 into 10 square, 10 raised to 5 plus 2, 7. So you can say 1 Newton meter is 10 raised to 7 die centimeter. That is the relation between SI unit of turning effect of force and CGS unit of turning effect of force. So I conclude this video with all the topic, that is what is normal force, what is moment of force, what are the factors on which moment of force depends, what is the formula of moment of force, and all the applications of moment of force. Thank you for watching my video.